Florida's Democratic Party is demanding an investigation into reports of possible voter registration irregularities after some people claim they were duped into changing their party affiliation. The party's chair sent a letter to Florida's Secretary of State expressing concern over reports that senior citizens in a Miami-Dade public housing complex unknowingly had their party changed after updating their voter registration with people who ended up working on behalf of the Florida Republican Party. The controversy is highlighting these comments from Florida Governor Ron DeSantis back in November.
Today, for the first time in the history of Florida, we've now overtaken Democrats. There are more registered Republicans in Florida than Democrats.
360's Randi Kaye has the story.
They don't say they're going to change me to the party.
77-year-old Juan Salazar is a Democrat, or at least he used to be. In December, Salazar says someone wearing a bright red baseball cap approached him and switched his party affiliation without his consent.
You were a lifelong Democrat.
From 1978.
And now, all of a sudden, you're a Republican.
I'm a Republican.
You don't want to be a Republican.
I don't want to be.
He says it all happened at his housing complex in Miami, Florida. It's home to elderly, low-income residents who speak little English. He says he now believes it was a Republican who told him he needed to update his registration. But keep in mind, in Florida, once you register to vote, there is no reason to update that registration unless you want to make a change, like your party affiliation. That was not the case with any of the people we spoke with.
This is the old card.
That's an old card.
And it says right here, Democratic Party.
Yeah.
The new card says Republican Party of Florida. And that's not what you want.
No, I want to be Democrat.
Juan isn't the only one who may have been targeted. Miami resident Ernesto Morajon told us a lady in a red hat came to his door to try and register him as a Republican, even though he's a Democrat.
Now, I asked to her, are you Republican? And she told me, yes.
Ernesto refused to sign the form, but he says his sister and brother-in-law, both Democrats who live elsewhere in Miami-Dade County, had their registrations changed after being fooled.
It doesn't seem like a one-off kind of mistake. It is a concerted effort.
Senator Annette Tadeo is the vice chair of the Ethics and Elections Committee in Florida Senate. After receiving at least a dozen calls from concerned Democratic voters, Tadeo sent this letter to Florida's Secretary of State, a Republican, requesting an investigation.
About 10 minutes from where Juan lives, we found another woman who says her voter registration was changed from Democrat to Republican. She lives here. She didn't want to go on camera, but told us a woman had knocked on her door and told her that she needed to update her voter registration because it had expired.
That woman's daughter sent us these pictures her mother took of the woman she says recently changed her voter registration. Look closely at her ID. It says RPOF. That stands for Republican Party of Florida. The woman's daughter says her mother signed the form, but says after that, someone checked the box Republican Party under party affiliation. And her daughter says there is no way her mother could have checked that box on her own since it's in English, and her mother doesn't speak or read English.
It is not legal to fill out the form for people.
Yet the woman's voter registration was still changed. That's her old card on the left. It reads Democratic Party. Her new card on the right shows she's now registered with the Republican Party of Florida. All of this could have real consequences. Florida is a closed primary state. So in a primary election, you can only vote for a candidate that is aligned with the party you're registered with.
It seems like they're filling out the form for them because they, not knowingly, again, lifelong Democrats, would never have checked Republican Party of Florida. It does raise some very big red flags.
So Randi Kaye with me now. Randi, what does the state's Republican Party have to say about this?
Well, John, we reached out to the Republican Party of Florida, and the executive director told me that the party conducts voter registration in accordance with all applicable laws and regulations. She also said that they will review any report of concern and that election integrity is important and continues to be a priority for the Republican Party of Florida. But, John, I can tell you that there are hundreds of these third-party voter registration organizations throughout the state, and it is legal for them to reach out to voters. When it becomes a problem is if they didn't register with the state, or if they are filling out these forms for the voters instead of having the voters do it themselves, or if they're changing party affiliation without the voters' consent, then it becomes illegal. And that's what they're investigating. But I should also note that all of the voters we spoke with have already reached out to the Board of Elections. They're asking that their party affiliation be changed back to the Democratic Party. They are eagerly awaiting their new voter registration cards, hoping they'll come in the mail real soon. They haven't received them yet, but they're looking forward to becoming a member of the Democratic Party here in Florida once again, John.
Quite a story. Thanks so much, Randi Kaye. Miami-Dade County's Mayor Daniela Levine-Cava joins me now. Mayor, thank you so much for being with us. How many voters have you heard from here, and what are you asking for? You're concerned about this.
Yes, John, we're very concerned. We first learned about this in September. We immediately brought the case to the attention of the state attorney's office. And then in December, there was a news story, and we followed up. And now in February, we actually have photographs of a person who was admitted to this building. And we've heard now from dozens of people, and we're working with the state attorney's office to make sure that every single case is investigated and corrections made, and that we can find and resolve this. It's really a shameful situation. Here we have our democracy under attack, people who are really very vulnerable to this kind of fraud. So we're doing everything we can to resolve it and fix it.
What are you hearing from authorities on this about their investigation?
Our state attorney, Kathy Rundle, has issued a statement that she is going to fully investigate these cases, and my office is continuing to do its due diligence to bring cases forward.
Now, one of the things, my understanding is in Florida, you know, you don't have to do anything. If you're registered as a Democrat in Miami-Dade County and you're, you know, you live in one place, you never have to change anything. So this is someone actively going in and somehow...
Yes.
Doing something with you to get your documents shifted here. So there does appear to be at least some concerted effort from somewhere going on.
So I've understood that some people have been approached by saying, would you like your new voter registration card? So obviously people who are regular voters, they are concerned. They want to be sure they're up to date and everything is ready for the next election. So I think that people really are very, very vulnerable to this.
Have you heard from the governor at all on this?
No, I haven't. Certainly, we believe that this is something that should be of great concern to him and to the legislators who want to be sure that our election process is free and fair. And we hope that the Republican Party will be doing its due diligence to make sure that all of their voter registration outreach is done correctly.
And just finally, up until this point, have you heard of any cases or many cases where people's registrations are being shifted from Republican to Democrat?
No, sir, I have not.
Mayor Daniela Levine-Cava, we appreciate you being with us. I hope that authorities do get to the bottom of this.
Thank you.